Hello dear students, in our last class we studied about quadratic equation. We learned how to form a quadratic equation, how to find the roots of quadratic equation. In that we studied how to find the roots by factorization. Today we are going to learn the other method, that is completing the square method. I will explain this through one example. Consider one quadratic equation, x square plus 4x minus 5 equal to 0. We need to convert this equation into a square form. That means we need to convert this equation into identities. We have already learned identities that represent the squares. They are a plus b all square is equal to a square plus 2ab plus b square. The other identity that represents square, a minus b all square is equal to a square minus 2ab plus b square. These two identities we have learned already. Now see, our first step, check which identity we need to apply here. For that, consider the coefficient part of x. If this part is positive, we can apply the first identity. If this part is negative, we can apply the a minus b whole square identity. Okay, that is the first step. Clear? Now see the equation. X square plus 4x minus 5. X square plus 2ab means, see here, 4x plus b square here minus 5. That is, here 5 is not a perfect square, right? So we need to rearrange the equation. For that, take all the x terms in LHS and integer part into the RHS. So x square plus 4x equal to this minus 5, when going to the RHS side it will be plus 5. Till that clear? Okay, then what is the next step? Now see, this equation is in the form x square plus 2ab. A square plus 2ab, right? So here we don't have b square here. So for that, we can write it as a square plus 2ab format. X square plus, instead of a square, x square plus 2ab. What is 2ab? 2ab means 2 into a into b, right? So similarly, we can write 2 into, what is a here? X into, what is b? Then what will be the term b? That is 2. 2 into 2, 4. Right, so equal to 5. This is 2 into a into b. Okay, 2 into a into b. Now we got the term b. Right, so now this is the form x square plus 2ab plus b square. Instead of b square, we can write 2 square. Got it? Instead of b square, we got here b. So instead of b square, we write 2 square. Now, when we are adding a new term to the LHS side, same way we need to add the new term into the RHS side also for balancing the equation. Got it? Here 2 square is a new term. When we are adding the new term to the LHS side, we need to add it on the RHS side also for balancing the equation. Is it clear? Okay. Now see, this is the form for a square plus 2ab plus b square form, right? Then a square plus 2ab plus b square is equal to a plus b whole square. They both are equal. The same way we can write it a plus b format. So what is a here? X plus What is b here? 2. X plus 2 whole square. Is it clear? This is equal to this. Now, is equal to 5 plus 2 square means 9. Okay. Till that clear? Now, see. X plus 2 whole square equal to 9. Then what is x plus 2? Yeah. Is equal to square root of 9. Clear? Now we got it as perfect square. So if square root of 9 means it will be plus 3 or minus 3. How? 3 into 3 is 9. Similarly, minus 3 into minus 3 also plus 9. So we will get two answers, plus 3 and minus 3. So don't forget to apply this plus or minus sign. So the equation we will get x plus 2 is equal to plus 3 and x plus 2 is equal to minus 3. From this we can find the x value, right? X equal to 3 minus 2 equal to 1, and here x equal to minus 3 minus 2 equal to minus 5. So we get two values, x equal to 1 and x equal to 5. Just listen here. If you feel difficulty in this step, there is another method also. That is, just avoid this step. If you feel it is easy, you can follow this. Otherwise, another method also there. Till that clear, no? X power plus 4x plus 4x equal to 5. Till that clear. We group the x terms together and move that integer part into the RHS side. X square plus 4x equal to 5. Now see, the coefficient part of x square is 1. 1 is the coefficient of x square. So here, what is the coefficient of x? Yeah, 4. E, always ensure that the coefficient part of x square is 1. Then you can directly apply this method. That method is, take the coefficient of x, that is 4. Okay, now divide the coefficient of x by 2. That will be the value of b. Okay. When the equation is given coefficient of x square is 1, you can directly do like this. Just take the coefficient of x part, divide it by 2, you will get the value of b. If the coefficient of x square is given like 2x square, so that means instead of this, if you are getting 2x square, first we need to convert this as coefficient 1. That means we need to make it as a perfect square. Here 2x square is not a perfect square. So we need to convert it as a perfect square. How we can convert? Yeah, we can divide this by 2. That means 2x square divided by 2. 2 and 2 cancel. Then we will get the equation like coefficient like 1. Clear? Okay.